Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the Coastal Radar Chain Network. We will discuss about what it is, what is its major aim, and what kind of information it will help India in its domain awareness of the maritime security. So these are the basic things that we will discuss in this video. So let's start. First of all, let's try to understand what is this. So it is a network of information and maritime domain awareness in Indian Ocean region. So where this particular coastal network radar will be actually functional, it will be in the Indian Ocean region. And what is going to be its target? So it is going to create a network of information and maritime domain awareness, like what all is happening in the maritime security. It is going to collect that data. That is the major purpose of that radar system. This will also help India in its initiative known as Sagar. So you guys must have heard about the Sagar initiative, which is your security and growth. Security and growth for all in region. And which region we are talking about? For all in region. So this is your Sagar approach, which has been mooted by the Prime Minister of India. And this Sagar approach says that the Indian Ocean region, all the littoral state, which means which have the boundary towards the Indian Ocean, all these state should have the idea of growth and the security. So that is the Sagar approach which India has started. And this particular initiative of the Coastal Radar Chain Network will also help India in pushing forward with this Sagar approach. The primary aim of surveillance radar design is to detect and track small fishing vessels for coastal surveillance application. So you must have been aware that in India, the Coastal Guard, there is a different wing, a separate wing in Indian defense system, which is under the Ministry of Defense itself. Coast guards are there who kind of surveil across the coast of India all the time. So they are already in place, and for that purpose, this coastal radar surveillance would be specifically focused on tracking and detecting a small fishing vessel. It will also help in monitoring any illegal activities in the sea. Now, this is also important that Indian Ocean region is a place where India has a lot of strategic importance. In that regard, any kind of illegal activities which happen in the sea could eventually weaken the maritime might of India, and in that regard it is important that the illegal activities in the sea are also monitored. So this particular radar chain network will help in that also. So these are the major details regarding the Coastal Radar Chain Network. Now let's try to understand about the Information Fusion Center for Indian Ocean Region. Why? Because we just learned that this radar network chain is going to collect the information. Where it's going to feed the information? So all the information that gets collected by that radar will go to the Information Fusion Center for the IOR. So this is the place where all the collected data will eventually go. Where it is? It is established at Gurugram, which is Gurugram, earlier it is known to Gurugram. It is co-located with the Information Management and Analysis Center. So Indian Navy has a Information Management and Analysis Center, which is now going to be renamed as the National Maritime Domain Awareness Center. So National Maritime Domain Awareness Center. And that is what it is going to be renamed as going forward. So your Information Management and Analysis Center is going to be called as the National Maritime Domain Awareness Center. And it also collects the information, and it is co-located with the Information Fusion Center for the Indian Ocean region. It is a hub of maritime security information in the IOR region through wide shipping information exchange agreement. Now for your understanding, let's try to also understand what exactly is wide shipping. So wide shipping, as the name suggests, is about actually the non-military vessels. So non-military merchant vessel information, like the prior and advance information about the non-military merchant vessel in the ocean, is what is called as the white shipping. So we have a white shipping agreement with various nations, and that means that this information fusion center for the Indian Ocean region in India is kind of a hub of maritime security information in the Indian Ocean region. And why India put so much resource in the Indian Ocean region? So you can understand that for India, Indian Ocean region is definitely strategically very important, because our all the trade, like all the naval army as well as our water bound trade, the shipways, all the waterways and the ship bound trade is through the Indian Ocean region. So Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, both of these are very important for the India's, from the strategic point of view, also for the economic point of view as well. So that is why India put a lot of effort and lot of understanding to collect the information, as well as to help the other countries also in the Indian Ocean region to kind of negate the might of China. So there is also a China factor which get played in the Indian Ocean region, where China has been trying to push its might across the region, but India is also trying to say that this is strategically very important region, and for that it is also trying to help the other nation as well in the Indian Ocean region. So this is the more of what you can understand as the context. Now let's just quickly see what are the other related initiatives. So the Council of Ministers of Indian Ocean Rim Association countries met virtually in December 2020. So this has also happened, that the Indian Ocean Rim Association also had a virtual meeting very recently. What is actually IORA? So it is an intergovernmental organization established in 1997, and India is a member country. Now there is a question for you. Let me know whether Pakistan is also a member country of IORA. So I will look out for the comments in the video section, that do you know whether Pakistan is also a member of a IORA or not. India is a member, just remember that. Then we also recently conducted the Malabar exercise. Generally it used to be the which countries? Actually it used to be Japan, US and India, but this time Australia also participated. In fact, you can understand all the countries which are part of Quad. What is Quad? I hope you know, and you will answer me in the comment section of this video, that all these four nations which are also associated with Quad recently conducted the Malabar exercise on the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. And finally, earlier this year in March, India joined the Indian Ocean Commission as an observer. What is this Indian Ocean Commission? It is actually a regional institution of the Western African Indian Ocean region. Which countries are actually member of IOC? So you heard of Cameroon. Cameroon is there, Madagascar is there. You must have at least heard of the movie. So Madagascar is there. Then we have Mauritius, Seychelles, and the Reunion Island. So these are the member of Indian Ocean Commission. And just remember that part, that India has not become a member but has gained an observer status. So this is something you should remember, not a member but an observer status. Indian Ocean Rim Association, India is a full-time member. So these are the things you should know about the Indian Ocean region. These things are also important for your IR perspective. So when you are writing about the Indian Ocean region, its challenges which India faces, strategical importance, and what all India has done, you can quote everything we have studied in this video. So that is important from that perspective too. From your prelims point of view also, they at times ask about the organization, international organization and bodies. So from that perspective, IORA and IOC are important. So I hope you have understood this video. If you still have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.